Hi all, have you thought about the fact that some tools and services cost exact amount of money? And if you see some offer that just looks too good to be true, for example, you're buying some tools and they look like too cheap and they're still stated to be originals, it might be a trap, and actually it will be. In today's video, I'll share you the story that one of the subscribers has sent to me, and actually that will be very spectacular, how usage of tools of non-original quality or just fakes can cause damage to the car and actually cost you even more money. I'm Vladimir and you are on the BMW channel. That will be very short but super spectacular video. Why you have to know your tools. Today briefly I'll talk you about such a thingy. It's actually called ICOM B. It is the adapter that is used together with original ICOM. Original ICOM is the tool that looks like that one. It is used to program the BMWs of all series. E, F, G, I, whatever series, that tool is used to program the BMWs. But did you know that older BMWs, BMWs from E series, they do have such a bus that's called MOST, or it's fiber optics. Okay, obviously F and G series also have the same bus, but the difference is that for the E series, in order to program the head unit or the multimedia, you will require special adapter to the ICOM. It's called ICOM B, because without that, it will be impossible to program the head unit, because just the amount of information will be like too big to send into the head unit and it will just fail. That's why that adapter is a must. It is not required on F or G series anymore because Ethernet bus was introduced in F and G series, and that's why all the internal communication inside the car is done through Ethernet bus. But on the E series with the MOST fiber optics, it's used between the multimedia devices because it just allows the great bandwidth or the amount of information sent to different multimedia parts of the BMW, and that special adapter is required to program it. So the story of one of the subscribers, how he has purchased the ICOM B, he purchased the Chinese clone, and you would assume that purchasing the clone tool will make exactly the same job, and you will actually see that that's not the case always. Our typical assumption is that if we are purchasing the non-original tools, the clone tools, those will at least make the work at the same quality. Okay, maybe a bit less, but they should still work. Later on in the video, I'll show you how the Chinese ICOM B looked like and how huge fake it is. It's just ridiculous. So, the story of one of my subscribers, and actually it is a very good story, everybody has to learn from that. By the way, if you do have any similar stories, absolutely feel free to send me any photos, videos with short description, and we'll see, maybe part two of the same series will occur. As I already told you, to program the head unit of E-series, which has the MOST bus, you will require ICOM B. That tool looks like that one. You connect ICOM B to regular ICOM, it's called ICOM A, through the USB cable. And then you connect that tool to the fiber optics of the BMW itself, only on E series. On F and G, it's not required anymore. My subscriber, he tried to update the head unit of the BMW. It had CCC head unit, or car communication computer. That head unit actually consists from 5 different ECUs inside one. You can see it on that picture, for example. In order to program those, you have to program those in a specific sequence. Some of those are programmed just over the ICOM or with that one, and some of those require fiber optics connection to program those, because just the bandwidth is too great. Without fiber optics, it will just fail. So he connected everything as it should be done by the factory, no errors from his side. He started the programming of the head unit and it failed. he was thinking, okay, maybe it just happens, because actually if you're programming the head units of the E-series, even using all the original tools, it still can fail. It just happens sometimes. He tried to recover, no luck. It was still not working. So one of the CCC multimedia head units just was bricked, and the only way to recover that is to use the original tool or to recover it on the bench. Okay, you might think it might happen. Yes, it just might happen sometimes. So the next thing he was trying to do, again, update the head unit of another E-series, and that time it was CIC, or car information computer. And again, during the programming, it failed. By that time, he started to suspect that, okay, something might be wrong with either the head unit itself, but because he was programming already the second head unit and still getting the same error, or with actual the tool. So he has disassembled the same ICOM B, and the picture he has seen, it's just a nightmare. Of course, there is like absolutely zero chance it will work, because Chinese manufacturers, they have exceeded even themselves. That picture is over here. Have a look. On current picture, you can see that actually there is almost nothing inside. There is only the USB connection over here. As you can see, it's with the red circle. And there are just a couple inner wires in the PCB board that's running to the LEDs that will emulate that that device should work. But there is nothing that's connected to the fiber optics itself. So there is absolutely zero chance that fake tool will work. Let's analyze the picture, what Chinese have done. Basically, they have just emulated the tool that it will work, but there is absolutely zero chance. Over here, you can see the two lights. I'll connect the same tool to the USB. So I'll just show you what the Chinese have done. Basically, the only intent of that tool, it was just to emulate. If we connect to the USB, the light will start to blink. So you can see the system is working. If the MOST, the actual fiber optics, is also connected, the MOST light also should work. But they have done just the wiring to the LEDs. It's just emulating. There is absolutely nothing inside. And we might assume there is zero chance it will work. Now let's disassemble the original tool and let's compare those two pictures side by side, and you will see how much hardware is actually required inside the tool to work properly. As you can see over here, there are way more components inside, and of course there should be, because in order to connect to the fiber optics, you should have something that's running somewhere connected to the PCB with the inner transistors and everything connected to the processor and so on. For better comparison, I'm putting side to side the two pictures, and you can see with your own eye what's the difference between the original and non-original. It's a very spectacular picture. It's just telling the story by itself. So it is absolutely the new level by the Chinese manufacturers. So they are not even pretending to make something that's working. Okay, not as good as the original, but at least it's working. They're making absolutely the new level. It's just super deep fake. So you might wonder, okay, Vladimir, what's like the learning point for that? Of course, we know that the original tool will be always than the fake clone tool. I'm not telling you that use only the original. Of course, like using only the original is always the best solution. But you might understand that original tools will cost way more money. And that's why if you're choosing non-original tools to clone tools, you have to understand with what parts of the car you are working. For example, in current case, the only damage was the actual multimedia of E-series. The CCC head unit or CIC head unit, the price of that in European market is around like 300-400 euros. Of course, it's not the new one. So the amount of the damage you have suffered is $300-400. If you're working, for example, with newer cars, with the G-series, and you are trying to make the chip tuning on the engine ECU, if you'll make any damage to that because of the poor quality tool, you will have to pay maybe sometimes like $1,500 euros or even $2,000 euros, so the amount of the responsibility is way higher. Among the tools that I'm using, majority of the tools are original, but I also do use some non-original tools. But the way to use non-original tool, the main rule I want you to remember, never, I say again, never try it on the client's car. First, if you want to use non-original tool, you can use it, but try it on your own vehicle or on single ECU you purchased from the scrapyard, so you make sure at least it's working. Because sometimes, if you disassemble the Chinese tools, inside they will look very similar. Of course, the components used will be cheaper and so on, but if you don't have original to non-original to compare, you will not make the difference. And that's why the only way to test it is actual battlefield test on the actual car or ECU itself. I hope you did find that video useful and you have learned something from that. If you do have any story, interesting story to share with me, or any friend of yours has the story to share with me, absolutely feel free to contact me. You'll find all the required contact information in under the description of every single video. Of course, feel free to like or subscribe to the channel if you do found the information I'm sharing with you useful. And see you next time. Bye.